We encourage you to reflect and learn more about Memorial Day and the men and women in your life and in our community that sacrificed their lives for the United States of America. I will now turn the program over to the Boy Scout Troop 148 for the presentation of colors and the flag salute. And at this time, I'd like to introduce my friend and Temecula Valley Symphony Board President, Sousa Miyamoto, for a few announcements and to introduce the Temecula Valley Symphony. Welcome to the Temecula.
Shorter than Zak. Good evening. Isn't it a beautiful evening for a concert, an outdoor concert? We are so honored to be invited each year to perform in the city of Temecula's Memorial Day concert. A little bit about the symphony, there are about 55 musicians this evening, and a good number are from this area. They live and work in Temecula or Temecula Valley. We also have musicians coming from all over, from San Diego, Orange, San Bernardino, and Northern Riverside counties. So they come from all over to be with us. We are getting ready to unveil our 2023-24 season, and you'll want to get on our mailing list to get the latest information. The symphony also has a youth symphony, where young musicians in the valley get the experience of playing symphonic music in a fun and supportive environment. And you can visit our website at TemeculaValleySymphony.org to learn more about the youth symphony programs and about the symphony. Several of our board members are sitting at this table over here to my left, and there's a sign up for our mailing list. And we also have little flyers with a QR code that you can visit our website and also sign up there. Okay, so please sit back and enjoy the concert. And now I'd like to, I invite you to please welcome our maestro, John Mario, to the podium.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Please stand for our national anthem. U.S. had most of its battleships either sunk or heavily damaged or stuck in the mud in Pearl Harbor. Miraculously, our carrier force escaped, but the Japanese had a plan to lure our carriers into battle and destroy all of them. Fortunately for us, we had cracked the Japanese code. So the United States was down to its last Greek operational carriers. The Yorktown being heavily damaged was put to sea very fast. So with the cracked code, they were able to intercept the Japanese task force. And we had one carrier sunk and the Japanese had four. It was a very decisive battle and was the turning point. So this is music of John Williams. It's called Midway March.
Thank you.
Now, an interesting thing about this piece is that John Williams supposedly put the, remember we're talking about breaking the code, that the code is in here somewhere in the rhythm, and I think it's at the beginning, the da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I don't know what that code is, but apparently that's, it was written right into the music. So our next, we got a lot of C pieces tonight. The next piece is also about the sea. It's called Hands Across the Sea. And at its premiere, it was so popular that it was played 3 times in succession. So it was written by John Phillip Sousa, and the Hands Across the Sea were to no specific allies, but to our friends overseas. Now, one of the difficulties we have in the orchestra is that most of Sousa marches are arranged for band. So we tend to do the same marches over and over again. We're very fortunate that our maestro, he has arranged this, so this is a world premiere of this march for orchestra that you're about to hear. Please welcome Mike Sobe.
Thank you.
Now we're going to change things up a little bit. I was told that country music is very, very popular in Temecula. Yeah, see? Yeah. All right, so what are you doing with symphony music in Temecula? I like country music. But we have something close to country music. We have some cowboy music coming up next. Unfortunately, it's a ballet. So the ballet is called Rodeo, which is really Rodeo, but it's like Rodeo Drive, right? We say Rodeo. And it's by Aaron Copland, and the piece is called Hoe-down.
Thank you.
So how did we do? Was that cowboy enough? All right. No! I like a guy right there. He's like, says when he speaks his mind. That's a good thing. Our next thing is, we're very excited because we're launching a new series of concerts, kind of along the vein of a mostly Mozart. So this is a slightly pared down orchestra playing what's called chamber orchestra music. So if you think of something like a stock car, racing car, this is more like Formula One racing. Right, or you know, if you have a battleship, this is more of a battle cruiser. Right, it's a little leaner and meaner, but with the same kind of firepower. And this is a Mozart called the Haffner Symphony. It was originally repurposed music. It was for an ennoblement, which I guess what happens when a noble person becomes noble. Right? I guess it's like a bar mitzvah for noble people. The guy's name was Haffner, so the symphony got its nickname, Haffner. Mozart liked this music, it was a whole bunch of other music, and then he repurposed it into the symphony. We're going to hear the very first part. Victor Barber routine up here with the music going around. So here's one for the bad guys. This is from the 1980 movie The Empire Strikes Back, and it's Darth Vader's theme.
Thank you.
So that's music that has been described as among the saddest music ever written, right? But now we're going to brighten things up a bit. We have a little tradition here. We play a medley of all the Armed Forces tunes called the Armed Forces Salute. And if we have veterans in the audience today, we ask them to hear the theme, or the anthem of your branch of service. Please stand and be recognized.
Thank you.
So now here is a march that got its name by coincidence. This is another march by Sousa, and he had some leftover music from an operetta kind of made it into a march but hadn't gotten a title yet. And his bandmaster and Sousa, they attended a ceremony where the Liberty Bell was dropped at the end. And at the same time, Sousa got a letter from his wife saying that his son marched in a parade in honor of the Liberty Bell. So there it was the Liberty Bell. And he all had to do is add bells. Do we have our Liberty Bell ready to go? Here's our Liberty Bell right there. It doesn't have a crack in it. Fire it up, let's hear it. Yeah. This is Liberty Bell march.
Thank you.
So the symphony is thought of mainly as a European thing, right? But what if there were a symphony that was dedicated to the United States or to the New World? Well, in late 1800s, Czech composer Antonin Dvorak got a post in New York City and at a music conservatory and was teaching there, and then took a tour of the United States and spent a lot of time, especially in the Midwest. And he was so impressed by the vastness of open spaces and also of folk music, folk tunes, Native American tunes, and spirituals. So he wrote a symphony called To the New World, where he incorporated a lot of these folk tunes. And here's the finale from that symphony.
Thank you.
first of all, please join me in acknowledging our fabulous orchestra who fought the winds and the sun and placed a beautiful dream. And thank you all for being such a lovely audience. We're going to end with what has become a tradition here, which is the Stars and Stripes by Sousa.